In this video, I want to give just a quick overview of the Welch Allyn, the different components of it, different ports, and just basic user interface stuff. So the Welch Allyn itself, it's here. Hassel comes with a power supply, looks like this. On the back here, you'll have the battery compartment. To get to the battery, you'll need to have a Phillips head screwdriver. Take this top screw out. And there you have your lithium ion battery with a connecting port down there. It's a fairly standard lithium ion battery with a ferrite choke. You just want to make sure that you plug this in. It can only go in one direction, so when you plug it in, you want to have the key match up with that hole over there. This also acts as a latch, so when you take it out, you need to squeeze the top of it and then pull it out. Back in, close the door up. On the back here, you have the various ports for the device. You have your power port there, Ethernet, you have the SpO2 sensor will connect there, and you have the blood pressure cuff that will connect there. You also have two different USB ports. On the back here, you would have the mounting points for a bracket that would hold it onto a pole. I currently don't have one of those, but this is where it would attach to. To power the device on, really all that you need is just the power cable. And you just put it in, match up the arrows. You can kind of see the arrow on the top of this power port here. Just match it up with the arrow on the top of this plug and it'll snap in. And from there it should probably plug it in first. When you plug it in, you see the power supply will light up, and then this will light up as well to show that it's receiving power. If it has a an orange light, that means that it's charging. If it's solid green, that means that it's been charged. It's just running off wall power. So turn it on, just press and hold the power button. You'll see this light flash a couple times, and then the screen will update. Does take a little while to start up. These are generally not devices that are shut down. They're usually left on all the time, and that's sort of what they're designed to do, so they're not really the fastest thing to start up in the world. So you can see here that there are, this is the main interface. You can see that up here at the top, it's already showing that it's complaining a little bit because we don't have the temperature probe as well. The temperature probe, by the way, would connect down here and would sit inside of this device here, and you'd have the plastic shields in this holder right there. So you can see it's doesn't have the temperature probe, doesn't have Ethernet or internet or anything like that. The main controls down here you have for a patient, where you would enter in patient information that could be sent to a database. You have the review, which will give you a listing of all of the patients and their measurements. That you could then send to a database. You have your main settings page where a lot of the typical stuff is in here. You can set the date and time. If you have a Active Directory set up, you can log in as a clinician. Also advanced settings as well, where you do your networking. If I go back to home here, you'd have the main controls where you could start reading. you could start a pressure check, and you would see all the other information here. To shut the unit down, just hold the power button down and you'll see this menu come up, and you can either do sleep or you can do power down. Power down, it'll show a green screen like this, and then it'll turn off entirely. And that's it. That's the basics of the general overview of the device and how it operates.